CFO Studio is sponsored by Real Estate Strategies Corporation, advisors to CFOs, management, and boards of directors in the acquisition and disposition of leased and owned real estate. Visit us online at realstrat.com.
Hi, this is Andrew Zizas, your host at CFO Studio. I'm joined today in the studio by Mr. Ned Mavromatis, Chief Financial Officer of ID Systems, Inc. Ned Mavromatis' experience includes public and growth companies in a broad range of high technology industries, including wireless, machine-to-machine, RFID, enterprise mobility, analytics, and business intelligence. Mr. Mavromatis' focus is on strategic planning, operational improvements, investor relations, mergers and acquisitions, bank relations, and public offerings of equity. Mr. Mavromatis received a Master of Business Administration in Finance from New York University's Leonard Stern School of Business, and a Bachelor of Business Administration in Accounting from Bernard M. Baruch College, the City University of New York. Mr. Mavromatis is also a certified public accountant. ID Systems, founded by two engineering classmates at Stanford University in 1993, has pioneered the use of machine-to-machine technology for wireless vehicle management and fleet tracking. ID Systems is a leading global provider of wireless M2M solutions for securing, controlling, tracking, and managing high-value enterprise assets, including rental cars, industrial vehicles, trailers, containers, and cargo. The company's patented technology addresses the needs of organizations to monitor and analyze their assets to increase efficiency and productivity, to reduce costs, and to improve profitability. ID Systems went public in 1999. Its shares trade under the symbol IDSY in the NASDAQ Global Select Market. Mr. Mavromatis is here today to talk to us about a very interesting and dynamic topic, the Internet of Things and machine-to-machine technology. Ned, it's so nice to have you here on CFO Studio. Thanks for joining us.
Andy, thanks for having me.
So we're here to talk about a really cool topic, the Internet of Things and machine-to-machine technology. So for those who are watching who aren't familiar with either of those terms, what are we talking about?
Well, Andy, the Internet of Things or machine-to-machine technology basically allows any asset to be connected to the Internet. Once that asset gets connected to the Internet, that asset becomes intelligent. So the assets are able to speak to each other. They're able to send information back to the Internet. So you, as a user of those assets who have information, not only where those assets are, but you can collect information about who is using the assets, the percentage of time they're being used, how they're being used. So you can use all that information to use your assets more effectively and more efficiently.
That does sound cool. All right, so I get that. It's about communicating between assets and gathering information. All right, so help me understand. Give me some examples of how assets are connected on a machine-to-machine basis and how they can be used.
Well, I mean, Andy, for example, you can install a device on a forklift truck in a manufacturing facility.
Okay.
So you're able to control access to this piece of equipment to ensure that only authorized and trained operators can get on this piece of equipment. You can also collect information. So when this vehicle is in motion, or when it's pulling, when it's lifting, then you can use that information to maintain this piece of equipment more effectively. If there's a problem with the equipment, without any human intervention, the equipment can communicate with maintenance and they can schedule the vehicle to come in for preventive maintenance. If the problem actually makes the environment unsafe, the equipment now will be intelligent enough to shut itself down so it could avoid bigger issues. In that same manufacturing facility, if the production line needs material, it would automatically send a message to the equipment where the driver can bring material when needed, so it would avoid the line, the manufacturing line, from going down. If you're a shipping company, for example, and you want to ship something, you can actually use technology on your trailers to find out where your closest available trailer is, so you can schedule that trailer to come in to pick up, to ship that product, so it improves efficiency.
Wow.
Yeah, if the trailer, for example, is a refrigerator trailer, mm-hmm. you can actually control and monitor the refrigeration so you can avoid spoilage of the goods that are being shipped. Mm-hmm. Another example is a hotel. They can actually control the lighting, the temperature in a room based on a guest preference, so it would improve the whole customer experience. You
know? My mind is racing with possibilities, but I think I heard at least five categories. I heard that this approach affects use of assets, the security and safety of assets and the people who use them, general operations, of course, but I also heard maintenance, inventory control, and then your last comment was, you know, customer experience.
Exactly.
And I'm sure that distills down into a lot of benefits. But and that's just the first things that are coming to my mind. I'm sure you guys have thought about a lot more of this. So, okay, I get that. And this is very exciting. But tell me why the Internet of Things and the concept of machine-to-machine technology has exploded. Because I know this is a huge growth industry.
Yeah. A lot of that, Andy, has to do with the costs coming down significantly. If you look, for example, at the cost of the devices and the sensors that get attached to the asset, that cost has come down significantly. In addition, the cost of connecting to the internet has come down. As well, there's been significant improvements in the area of power management technologies, which extends the battery life of the devices and those sensors. So while the costs were higher, this technology only made sense to be installed on high-value assets.
Originally.
However, yeah. As the costs are coming down, now it opens the possibility to attach it to any asset.
Anything. So, ergo, the explosion of the industry, because you're saying costs come down, so it just makes sense to do it almost everywhere now.
Sure. The return on investment is there as you look at comparing many different assets as well.
So as the costs come down and the industry continues to grow and the application takes place on more and more devices and assets, I've got to believe that the explosion also creates an explosion of data. This has got to pose a big data issue, yes?
Well, Andy, it's all about the data. Yeah. I think the winners in the space are the companies that are going to focus on the data and the analytics, because all these assets are going to provide a lot of useful information.
So more so than the companies that build the box and provide the box. You really think this is about information?
Absolutely. I mean, if you can imagine Walmart, for example, has 137 distribution centers. If you can take all the data provided by their assets and you're able to give them analytics on how productive each and every one of their distribution centers are, and then they
every
can...
Every forklift, every device, every asset
within those distribution centers.
Wow.
Then they can rank them and see which distribution centers are more productive. However, you can also feed in data from the rest of the industry so they can compare where they stand along their peers. In addition, if you have predictive analytics and they can make future decisions based on the historical data and can see how they can save money, it becomes very powerful. Also, as time goes by, when you look at the hardware that gets attached to the assets, that's going to become more and more of a commodity, right?
Yeah.
So the data becomes that more important.
So, wow. So a large company can gather this data, compare distribution center against distribution center, store against store, a forklift in Wyoming against a forklift's performance in Florida, against their competitors' information or their industry's information.
Right.
Wow, this is mind-boggling. The sheer volume, not just of information, but of what you can do with this. And yeah, I agree with you. This is not about the hardware, although it starts there, of course.
Right.
This is really about where you're taking your company, and it's about profitability, and it's about operating efficiency, and it's about risk management, I would imagine, right?
Exactly.
Wow, it's endless. So, okay, so you talked about the winners. So in your role as CFO, how do you embrace, you know, how do you benefit by embracing this technology?
Well, obviously, for a CFO, it becomes very important, right? Because now you have information about where all your assets are, how they're being used, who is using it. And when you look at the return on investment for this application, it's very high. However, it's not only about cost cutting. It's actually about risk mitigation.
Yeah.
It's about increasing revenue. And it's about improving the whole customer experience. You know, in the rental car industry today, rental car companies are using this type of technology to automate the rental and return of the automobile. So there's a unit that's installed in the rental car. When you pick up the car, it would communicate with the internet. It would say when you picked it up, how much fuel was in the car, how much mileage was in the car. When you return it, the same thing happens automatically. So your receipt is printed to you, it's printed and handed to you without any human intervention.
My mind's racing. I'm trying to stay focused because this is very cool and very exciting. So, I think I hear a positive impact on billing. Thinking as a CFO, my billing, budgeting, planning.
Absolutely. I mean, it changes the whole budgeting process.
Yeah.
You can have situations where you need to buy certain assets for some of your facilities or certain of your regions. But now you can have data and you can see maybe in other facilities or in other regions, those assets are being underutilized. Mm. So why buy new assets where you can transfer them? From a billing standpoint, you can use this technology to accurately charge your customers automatically. Mm. So it takes away all the manual effort and all the human intervention. So this would make the CFO's life a lot easier. And at the end of the day, when what this technology is going to do, it's going to help increase the enterprise value of the organization, which is very important for a chief financial officer.
That's what we're all looking to do, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, so the industry is exploding, but it's still in its infancy. Yeah? Tell me what the outlook is for M2M.
You know, Gartner says that the Internet of Things install base we will increase to 26 billion by 2020. And as I said before, as the costs go down, it would make sense to basically connect this type of technology to virtually anything.
To almost anything.
Yeah.
Wow. So it just keeps going and going and going.
Absolutely.
I think we have to buy your stock. Ned, listen, this has been great. This has been a very dynamic conversation. I want to thank you very much. As your company progresses and as your industry progresses, I hope you'll come back and see us again.
Absolutely. Andy, thanks for having me.
Thank you so much. This is Andrew Zizas, your host at CFO Studio, with Ned Mavromatis, Chief Financial Officer of ID Systems, saying thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again.
The CFO's Guide to Understanding Corporate Real Estate Transactions is packed with almost 200 pages of insightful real estate acquisition and disposition strategies. Request your free copy online at CFOstudio.com. CFO Studio is sponsored by Real Estate Strategies Corporation, advisors to CFOs, management, and boards of directors in the acquisition and disposition of leased and owned real estate. Visit us online at realstrat.com.